picture every meal, every place I'm at. And I think that we're seeing social media, which we're going to be talking a little bit more in a second. People are oversharing about, you know, their emotions, their breakups. And I think there's got to be a limit to how much we share, especially with that in turn being used against us too.
Oh yeah, definitely. But I mean, I'm talking about when someone goes on live and they're like, oh, I'm just walking through the parking lot.
That's for safety. I don't think we overshare. I think we're going green by scrapbooking our lives online, right? We're not printing out pictures. We're not wasting a lot of paper to document your lives. Okay, we're going green. You can unfollow, you can block anyone who might be oversharing for your taste. You don't have to have them on your feed or activity, right? So it's really about as much as you can overshare, you can also edit.
Doesn't that make people kind of sensitive though? Like, well,
kind
you
of.
You can't unfriend them, you can like unfollow them, but sometimes when that whole thing you may know comes up, and someone says, wait a minute, I thought you were on my friends list. What happened?
I didn't say you had to unfriend. I said
unfollow. I think that's dangerous. With that said, it's dangerous. If you're saying that every Saturday night you're at this club or this place or that's a popular place and you overshare that, then someone wants to talk wrong to you that you might not even know. We know what's wrong with you.
Well, that's the same thing for any dating app. Tinder, on Grindr,
oh,
they know how many feet you are away, right? So if you're talking about some serial harm here, that's a device that can be definitely used in that kind of way.
Yeah, there were some horror stories with Snapchat, just like when it first started. Like, you know, it enabled your location, so people literally would be able to see where you're at while you're Snapchatting, and people would just show up on you like that.
That
is pretty serious.
Still do that?
They don't do it anymore, but I remember that Kendall Jenner had an episode of that. I watched it on Keeping Up with the Kardashians.
Girl, quality TV at every turn.
So what about objectifying? Like, you know, you see a picture of a firefighter, a hot policeman, or a bodybuilder, you know, and you're like, oh, this is hot. I need to share this. Hey, Daddy.
You know what's so funny? That I just realized recently, this is probably on a side note, but on my Twitter, when I go on Twitter, all of a sudden, I guess I'm following Chichi LaRue, and all of a sudden, all this porn.
Yeah, she's definitely got
porn
out there.
I was like, oh my god, I'm so
you were appalled.
Because I'm around people as that's coming out, but
did you want to follow her?
I did not. I just wanted to share that it just keeps happening. But I think, you know, social media is an amazing tool. I think that what I do not like to see is when people are invading someone else's privacy. If you find somebody that's beautiful or attractive, and you take a picture of with your phone and you post it, you're in essence violating that person's rights to privacy, their private citizen. You know, and you see this all the time. You see it when men are without their shirt, and women for that. So you see more men, but it might be women. You know, it's used to sort of objectify people. But is it okay?
I think people have this attitude. Well, it's my social media. It's my page. It's my account. I'll do what I want to do.
Yeah, but you're invading in somebody else's life, and with the fact that things can go viral now, by you taking a video, you're invading somebody's life, but you don't even know. Perhaps you're taking a picture of somebody that you think is in a great place, but maybe they're going through stuff, you're capturing a vulnerable moment, maybe that person is with their spouse, or I mean their girlfriend that is not their spouse, and you're
busted. There should be some sensitivity about exploitation and exposure.
For sure.
I mean, we talk about you know, objectifying or taking somebody's photo or image or video. We talk about consent, right? Like, is it okay if I take a picture of you? Or there's ways to find a source of that picture that you're sharing. Just credit that source, right? So it's really about if you're gonna post the work, if you're gonna share something, credit and make sure that the source knows that Wisdom is aware that you're doing so.
Okay. I agree.
So we have one of our other squad girls who just walked on in. We just gotta fly this on in. Welcome to Chanel. Give her a round of applause.
Yeah.
So what about viral bigotry? That's really a big thing. Like, I know people have been sharing these videos across Facebook more recently. And particularly, homegirl Jasmina Saavedra. Does anyone remember this scenario a few weeks ago where this woman who's running for, is it Senate or Congress? City Council of the 44th District here in Los Angeles. And she was in a Denny's restaurant and there was a trans woman in the restroom. And this woman takes out her camera and she begins to record her. Harassment in the best, in like the worst way. So it's stuff like that, and it went viral. But that's as bigoted as it can get. That's like all hate.
I think that for me, I dare you to be horny while I'm in
the bathroom.
I wish you would. But I think that once she lost her, whatever she was going for, you know, local, she lost that election. But I think it shows. But it shows sort of the level of hatred and bigotry that we as trans people we're exposed to. Here you are in a place where you feel, you know, you can be sort of safe and be away from cameras, and here comes this broad with this camera and phone on your face. And I think she should be held accountable in the restaurant too, because they escorted the trans individual out of the restaurant and violated her rights. But we see this at every level, you know, and I'll admit that I'm a little guilty. I've seen some people with really bad toes, and I've taken a picture, and I've shared it, and, you know, I'm trying to be mindful that that is not the way, because you're contributing to the problem. Just get them cuffs done, though.
When we talk about viral bigotry and hatred, we also talk about, like, a call-out culture, a clap-back culture, a culture that we feel that where someone's feeling that they're in the right for saying what they're saying or posting what they're posting, right? So we have a difference in, like, someone doesn't see what their behavior is wrong, right? Even though they're objectifying and exploiting someone. And so it's really about censorship in a way that is allows everyone to feel safe. But that censorship is difficult to control and manage, particularly when we're in a place where we want net neutrality, where we want freedom of speech, right? But it's in those spaces, in a city, in a country, a county, in a state like ours, where we have certain protections. It's important that all citizens within these regions know what their rights and limits are.
Yeah, I totally agree. Like, for me, I think that just because, you know, we live in Hollywood now, and all major cities, I think everybody's trying to be a star. And so because people are so fixed on trying to be a star, or for all the likes on social media, they're just doing these things and they're not really thinking about the consequences and the hate that they're spreading. So for me, it's like, it's very hurtful. I mean, I've had situations where I was at the nail shop getting my nails done and I caught someone taking a picture of me, and I just, in a respectful tone, said, don't take my picture, thank you, and they respected that. And I think we have to definitely stand up to those types of situations when that happens, you know, in any situation, just be respectful. I go by a quote by Oprah that says, you are responsible for the energy that you bring into the space. So we have to definitely go into accountability and charging people for the things that they do. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, I think everyone is right, though. But social media is a tool that we all use. And I think, like, whichever platform you use, it's really about you being responsible for it. And responsible, like Chanel is saying, you are responsible for the energy that you put out there. And you're also responsible for the energy that you receive.
see. So if you're putting out that trash, that's probably what you're going to get.
And remember, when dealing with social media, you do not have to use all of your unlimited minutes. Keep some of them.
Yes, honey. So going back to the oversharing stuff, it is time for a squat picture. So I am going to take a picture with everybody this year. So ladies, if you would join me in getting up.
Okay.
And maybe some photo with the crowd. So it will come here. And ensure that everybody stand on this area. And I'm going to see you. Okay. So one, two, three. All right, I got that.
So we're going to talk about some ways that we show our pride. What are some of the ways that we show our pride?
So we're going to ask a few of you beautiful audience members to share with us how you show or display your pride. Would anyone like to share? Would you like to share with us how you display or show your pride?
I show my pride by making sure that I am talking about Pride Month and why it's important to me to all of my colleagues, my friends, especially the ones that aren't LGBTQ. I think it's really important for me to discuss with them why I'm so happy and so proud to be LGBTQ and identify as, you know, not straight. So that's the best part of my life.
Thank you. How about anyone in the set? Anyone want to share how you show your pride? I mean, I think showing up here is already displaying a little bit of pride. Anyone want to share an instance in the way they show their pride? Would you like to share?
Sure. So I think I don't know. One of the biggest ways I feel like I show my pride is that there's a lot of like social media like LGBT friends that I have too, and I always try to be extra supportive because I know like when they put themselves out there or when they say something. You know, it's really good to get some feedback. Even if you don't know the person, it's just nice to feel that. And I always try to do that, and likes are free, and you can always say something, like, nice and supportive.
I'm right there with you. I always, like or heart some, you know, reaction, showing reaction to just what people are putting out there. It's a great way to show support and pride. Thank you for sharing that.
You're a liker.
I'm a liker. I'm a lover.
Thank you all for sharing. We are here for it, definitely. Thank you.
Yes.
I'm living for those
names.
Oh,
man.
It's okay. We're all about empowerment. Right? So, you know what? We just want to do a sound check. So, on the count of three, let me hear some noise. One, two, three.
Woo!
I love it. Yes. Okay, so that just energizes a little bit. Thank you. So, we're going to go to commercial. And typically when we do an episode, we do have commercials, but today we brought you a little something special. And when we return, we're going to be back with our friends from the Trans Wellness Center.
Woo!
Okay.
But we're going to watch the monitor.
So I had an idea to put a show together featuring myself and these couples having discussions about trending topics the world around. Things we've learned along the way, and maybe even dishing a little tea. This isn't the same old story. It's not about the stumbling blocks in our way. It's about the roles we pave. Welcome to our world.
I'm Sheila.
And I'm Maria. And we're going to jump right in to the rundown.
Yeah, so here's our question that we posed to our audience, and we're going to talk about it too. So when you're looking for an address and get lost, do you turn down your music while trying to find your destination? Or you just keep jamming as you were before you realize that you were lost?
What do you do, girl?
Well, for me, I always like to concentrate if I'm lost. So I want to turn down the music. I want to be able to kind of like make sure I know where I'm going. I can be like bopping, but I'll go third way.
Yeah, sure. I usually do the Pandora and the navigation together,
yeah.
So that way you kind of turn the music
like,
down with the speaker. Yeah. Yeah.
just in a situation just last week where I was with one of my kids and we were looking for a restaurant that we were trying out. And we realized that we're lost and my phone is just like driving along. I'm like, wait a minute. I'm trying to use the navigation, but it's not through the Bluetooth, so we can't really hear it.
Well, no, we're actually, one of the great things about the Cures Wellness Center is that we're a collaboration of six different partner agencies, and so we're able to offer services and resources from six different agencies as opposed to just one, all under one roof, and including legal services, which would include what Dominique already mentioned, the immigration, benefits, navigation, employment, discrimination, and also legal name and gender marker change clinics. We would have referrals and warm handoff for anything that's outside of that spectrum for people who do need other legal assistance. But it's really great because of the partner agencies we're working with, Bienestar, La Latina Coalition, ABAIT, Friends Community Center, and Children's Hospital Los Angeles, in addition to the Los Angeles LGBT Center. And that's actually where our legal services are coming from right now, the legal department of the Los Angeles LGBT Center. And speaking of, our fearless leader, Maliana Marroquin.
Yay! Yeah.
I'm sorry for being late.
Thank you. I was putting this together. So
did you put
I'm
the cells
like,
or
no? I'm just kidding. A good friend of mine, yeah.
It's gorgeous.
So thank you and welcome for being here. So can you tell us a little bit about sort of the philosophy and the reason behind creating this transgender wellness? I know that you've been involved in this process for many years, and tell us how did that come about?
So the whole idea is that we always gonna pay attention to community. I think that's important. Many organizations create programs and interventions for our community, and they're not communities. So something that is unique about this place is that community is by community for the community. So we pay attention about what everybody's saying and everyone's needs. So that's why it made this place unique.
Yes, I know that it's also really important to be culturally diverse, and we see that throughout your staff. So tell us what you feel is the most important thing when it comes to providing services through a cultural diverse lens.
I think it's so important for a trans person who has questions to walk into a place where they can find someone from community. I think it makes a big difference when we come to a place and we are greeted by one of us. I mean, this is something important that when I started my transition years ago, I always looking for resources, and it was so challenging to find someone who gets me, you know. And this is a place where you don't have to tell me that much. I already know that you're in the right place, and I'm gonna make you feel that way. And staff also, and also the partners, we got the best of the best in Los Angeles. These are the people that have been doing this work for many years. So that's something that makes me so proud and made me feel confident that everyone coming to the place will be served in the best way that they deserve.
Yeah. Great. So when someone walks into the door, describe some of the steps that a client goes through.
That goes to Dominique.
First, I welcome them, you know, like just seeing them like walk in, like I'm already happy. Because I know that being trans, like you sort of like have like unspoken like feeling of like what they go through. So like kind of like see like oh, that, like you know, this person talks to me or whatever, so I just didn't. So I just like talk to them and we start like getting to know each other, and I think by that like we sort of build like some trust, and then I just sort of tell them about the services we offer. If it's something that's not within center, like we do referrals, it's something that we or goes into clients. And lately, not just with clients, but as well as like parents and loved ones that are trans clients. So that's the reflection. So like I can see like, you know, I can see this quality and stuff here. You know, new beginning for like the trans community and our allies and our families.
We've been getting a lot of, sorry.
It's okay.
I used to be part of this podcast. I'm just gonna jump in and start talking. No, it's beautiful that we've been getting a lot of emails from parents looking for resources for their kids and partners. So I've been reading all these emails, and in those days that I'm thinking like, this is too big for me to handle, I read those emails and I feel like we are in the right place and we're doing what is needed, you know. So I think that's something that I would like to share with people in the future about those messages of love and caring for families and partners. I think that's beautiful. Something new that is happening, yeah.
That's awesome. Well, speaking of resources, I know you guys have a table outside, right? Awesome. I'm sure more deets can be found there, and they can speak to all of you. But before you go, hold tight. We hope you can play a quick game with us.
Okay.
Did you play this game?
Yeah?
Sure,
yeah.
All right.
Well, all right. So this game is called N30. So we got our clock man over there,
yes.
DJ. So we play this game to get to know a little more about one another. And we play with our guests. So you get 30 seconds on the clock to answer a round of questions, okay? So say the first thing that comes to your mind. If one of your answers happens to be embarrassing, don't worry, because those are the best answers. Okay? So 30 minutes on the clock. I'll start with Mariana.
30 minutes?
Okay.
30
seconds.
Okay.
Your questions for Mariana. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I feel like the family view. 30 seconds on the clock, please.
Okay.
If you could turn any activity into an Olympic sport, what would you have a good chance at winning?
Swimming. I think I've been swimming now. I'm really good, like good at that, and I feel free, and I feel like I yeah, it's
okay.
Good. I feel surrounded and protected. I think it's good. Yeah.
30 seconds. What job would you be terrible at?
Working at McDonald's probably, because I will be eating all the time. Yeah.
Okay. book in them. What would your book be about?
Resilience, turning horrible things into humor and life lessons.
Okay. And if you could have a video of any one event in your life, what event would you choose?
I would like to see the moment when I was born, because my mom always said that she's thankful that I made her a mother, and that's the most beautiful thing for her. And she is my
everything. See, we get mushy here too.
Yeah. Sorry.
Thank you.
Okay, my turn, camera. So it has to be quick.
30 seconds.
What website do you visit most often?
What website?
Oh, website. Oh,
what
my
website
gosh.
Do you visit most often?
Oh, let's see. Probably I get my news from Mother Jones.
Mother Jones. What is something that is considered a luxury, but you don't think you can you cannot live without?
He's looking at me.
Yes. All right. What's your favorite genre of book of music?
Books or music?
Yeah, your favorite genre.
Oh. I'm gonna have to say blues.
How do you relax after a hard day of work?
Yeah. See, answering question two.
If you could have a never-ending candle that smells like anything you wanted, what fragrance would you want it to be? It's a never-ending candle.
Bergamot sandalwood.
Okay.
All right. We're going to try to do a quick around. Come on, Dominique, ready? Right? Okay. 30 seconds. What's your last adventure you went on?
This event.
All right. What is something you think everyone should do at least once in their life?
At least once in their lives. Oh, my God.
30 seconds.
Is it 30 seconds already? Oh, shoot.
That's a fun activity.
What is the most interesting place you've been?
Most interesting place I've been. I've been to.
It's a pageant girl.
I'm off.
Okay.
Oh, cool.
What is something you've been meaning to try that you just haven't gotten around to? What period of time best described your life?
Love Loves Los Angeles.
Hey.
Thank you. Well, thank you all so much for visiting. And Mariana, as always, it's great to have you home with us. And you do have a table outside, so please feel free to visit their resource table outside or their website. For more information, you can also visit our website for their details. Thank you all so much for joining us.
Thank
you're invited
you.
Anytime. Thank you.
Thank you. Mariana, Cameron, and Dominique.
Okay. So we're going to set up our next segment.
All right, so we're going to need a couple of volunteers. Anybody want to volunteer on this side?
I need a volunteer. I need two volunteers. Oh, one. Who wants to work?
Anyone else want to volunteer? There you go, double down here.
Would you like to work with me?
Yay.
Come over here.
Okay, Jesse, we'll go first and we'll give 15 seconds.
Go.
Matrix?
Calories.
In the classic board game of Monopoly, how much does it cost to buy a railroad?
$500.
What is the common term for a list of things a person would like to do before they die?
A bucket list.
Fine.
Ready? Go.
Which singer's real name is Stefani Joanne Angelina Garmontalia? What is the name of Batman's butler? Which movie features the song Ding Dong, the Witch is Dead? The character Sophia Brissett is played by what actress? In June 2015, who made their debut on the cover of Vanity Fair magazine?
Me. Right?
Well, let's tabulate. So you have three correct answers versus one. You are our winner. Woo! We have the fabulous Caviar Style Sea Sheet Volume Texture Foam Spray.
Thank you.
Thank you for your participation, y'all.
And you will not leave a loser. You also get a prize.
Yay.
She loves animals, and sci-fi is my favorite genre of movies and TV. Who would that be?
Shayla.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right.
All right.
Okay.
I think it's amazing. I was born and raised in Belize City. I took both piano and accordion lessons for 4 years. Oh, 4 years. In 1994, I met the Queen of England. I don't eat beef or pork. Which girl am I?
Yeah.
That's
not
me.
Chanel.
That's me.
I wish I met the queen of England. Okay. Alright, so this person was a linebacker in high school. She likes wearing granny panties. She loves edamame. And she loves Ross Desperado.
Wait, not yet. Wait. I'm gonna read the other person's, but as long as this, because if I read this one at the end, it'll be obvious.
Yeah,
okay.
Oh,
the person
right.
is.
Okay.
So let's see. This person is allergic to bananas. She was also on The Bold and the Beautiful. She's a vegetarian, and she played Cinderella in second grade. Wait.
Okay. So who
Hold
do
it.
You think
is
who?
Gia is what?
Gia Cinderella. And
hold it, we won't say yet.
Okay.
Go ahead, who's who?
Maria played on The Bold and the Beautiful.
Anyone else?
That's
Any other guess?
Gia.
You said
she
Maria?
She said Gia, and she said that I was The Bold and the Beautiful.
But that's the same person I'm looking at.
Oh, yeah.
Anyone else want to take a guess?
So that just goes, so again, this person was a linebacker in high school, likes wearing granny panties, loves edamame, loves Ross Dress for Less.
Who's that?
Okay, I think you love edamame, and I think you're on The Bold and the Beautiful.
Wrong. I wear the granny panties, and I was a linebacker.
She played Cinderella in second grade. She's also allergic to bananas.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yes,
awesome.
We had such a fierce time with you today. You're the best audience for sure. Give yourself another applause. We're happy to be here in your neighborhood. You never know what kind of neighbor you might have.
right? And we'd like to thank our neighbors from the Trans Wellness Center, Mariana, Dominique, and Cameron, who are here. And we also like to thank the TEACH program and LA Pride for sponsoring our prizes today.
And of course, our friendly neighbors here at Trans Pride LA. Thanks for having us.
So, we've reached the end of our show, and it's been a joy. We'd love for you to follow us on Facebook. Our Facebook page is Shayla and the Girls Next Door. We also have Instagram, but our show is monthly, so please log on and, you know, tell a friend. We hope that you've enjoyed, and always be nice to your neighbor, because she could be
a girl next door.
Thank you.
There's an open bar plan coming up soon. There's also dinner at 5:30, and the show starts from 8 to 9:30.
Hey all, Sherry here. That was a live filming of Shayla and the Girls Next Door. I'll be home soon, later this evening. Epilepsy awareness, trans awareness. Take care.